Hello everyone, welcome back to ConArchy YouTube channel. In our previous video, we introduced how the ETABS interface looks like and the various options and how to set up yourself before you start a design. So if you've not watched that video yet, try as much as possible to watch that before you come back to this one. So in today's video, we are going to model this simply supported beam and analyze it. So it's a 20 meter simply supported beam. There's our shear force and we also have our bending moment here. We have our pin support and a ruler support here with our 30 kN load in the middle. So let's start and model this beam and analyze it. So we open our ETABS app and we will go to a new model since it's a new model. So we click on new model. And we have our model initialization here. So this is where we will select our units of measurement and the codes we'll be using in our design. So use built-in settings weights. So these are the codes I'll be using for my design. In our previous videos, I showed you what you'll be setting up for yours. So if it's the same as yours, you click on OK. So mine is BS shapes that I'll be using. So OK. So I'm using the BS code in my design. So everything is set. And now this right here is the interesting part. This is where we set our grid lines for our model. So we have number of grid lines in X direction, number of grid lines in Y direction. So let's go back to our drawing and just look at the grid lines. So these are Y and X direction. So we are going to look at the grid lines that are cutting through this X direction and this Y direction. So this is X direction. We have one grid line here that is cutting through this X direction through the support and another grid line cutting through this support in the X direction. So grid lines in the X direction, we basically have two grid lines. So we go back to our app and select type in two. So number of grid lines in X direction, number of grid lines in Y direction. We have just one grid line cutting through the Y direction. So this is the Y direction. We have just one grid line that is cutting through this Y direction. So we select our box and put in one. So I'm going to input one in our Y direction. Spacing of grid in X direction. So in our two grid lines that we drew, we are going to look at the spacing between this grid line and this grid line. So we have 20 meters between them. So spacing between the X direction is 20, so you have 20 meters here, and again spacing in Y direction, we only have just one grid line, so we can't have spacing between them. But if there were to be like two spaces, maybe you can specify a specific number for the spacing. So we just have that, and we have the story dimension. I'm going to set the number of stories, so we just have one story. It's just one story. We don't have multiple stories on top of it, so yes, one story for the model. So once we are done setting everything, this is a simple model, so you don't need to make various or many changes. So you select grid only and click on OK. So just look at that. This is our plan view. We have plan view written here, and we also have 3D written here. With this 3D view, you can rotate it around. So all you have to do is click this 3D window, select the rotate, and you can just rotate it in any other way you want it to look. So we are going to select this window. So anytime you want to work on a particular window, you have to select the window before the changes happen to that window. So we are going to select this window. We want to work in the elevation view. We want to look at it in the elevation view. So elevation. It's on Y direction, like Y grid line, so one. So apply and okay. So this is the elevation view. And this is our grid line that we created, that we will be working on. So we have to draw a beam on this grid line. So we come to our construction elements, we have draw beam here. So we select the draw beam, come to this grid point, and start to draw a beam. So we click here and extend it to the last grid point. So just look at that. We have 20 meters. This supposed to tell us that our grid lines that we set in setting our grid line, we specify 20 meters. So we already have our 20 meters here. So every beam you draw here will be 20 meters. So we have our beam. So after drawing it, you have to press escape on your keyboard to leave that beam option. So this is one way to draw the beam. There's also another way I can teach you to draw a beam that is quite fast. So all you have to do is, we are going to let's delete this beam and use the other option. So you have to select this beam and press delete on your keyboard. So delete. So let's use this option. This is the quick draw beam. So for this option, let's select this option. It makes the drawing of the beam very simple, because the moment you touch the grid line, the beam just comes and you just click on it and it draws a beam so quickly. So these are various options you can draw your beam. So once you are done, we know that we have a pin support here and a ruler support here. So we are going to assign the support. So first of all, you have to click on this joint and come to assign. We are going to assign the support at the joint. So at this joint, we are going to assign a support. So that's a restraint. We are going to restrain movements. So restrain, and we now come here. So here we have fixed, this is a fixed support. This is a pin support. This is a roller support. And this right here is a hinge. So in our drawing, we had a fixed support at the far left. So these are fixed. So click on the fixed and select apply. Then we are also going to assign another support here, which a ruler support. So this is a ruler support. You click on it and apply to that joint. So we have our fixed and our ruler now. So once you are done, you just click on OK. So right now, what's left? Our 30 kilonewton point load in the middle of this beam. So for that, before you assign something to an element, you have to select the element. So this beam, you have to select it. So once you select it, it will look like the short dashes. So everything you are doing here is also replicated in the 3D view. So assign. It's a point load, but it's on a frame. We also have joint load. If you want to apply on a joint, we have shell load. That's a UDL for like a slab. So frame loads, point load. We also have distributed load here, but I'm going to pick point load since I'm working with a point load. So here we have various options here. Let me place it here so you can also look at the drawing, our model. So load type and direction, we have forces. Our load is a force, so you have to select forces. But if it's a moment you are applying, you also select moments. And we also have the direction of load application. The load is facing downwards. Our load is facing downwards, so it's in the direction of gravity. But in case it's in a different direction, we can change that x or y direction. We can change that. We also select absolute distance from end. So for the distance, our load is 10 meters from the first support, our point one. So distance, you input 10 meters, and our load is 30 kilonewton. So this is our distance and our load. Right here we have option, we have add to existing load. So on this frame, if there's already an existing load there and you want to add this 30 kilonewton to this, you have to select add to existing load. But if there's a load and you want to replace the load with this new load, you just click on replace existing load. So to replace the existing load with the 30 kilonewton I'm coming to apply. And if there's a load on the frame and you want to delete it, you just click on delete and you are done. So our load, the load pattern name, we have our dead load and a live load. We are going to assume our load is a dead load, so we are just going to click on dead load. And since you are done with everything, we just click on apply. Now just look at that. We now have our 30 kilonewton load right in the middle. So we have 10 meters here and also 10 meters here. So right now we are done with modeling the beam. So all we have to do is analyze this beam if there is a mistake or something. So we have to select analyze. We are going to analyze it and check model. So we have to check all these boxes, but there's a simple way. So select all. We also select the last option here. We check this box, then okay. So it's going to analyze this model to see if there's a warning message. So as it reads, model has been checked. No warning messages were generated. That means our model is okay. So we have to close this. And now we are going to run our analysis. So this button right here, like a play button, is where you analyze your model. So click on run analysis. So we have to save our model with a unique name. So we are going to stick name it simply supported, maybe beam, then save. So once you hit save, it will be running the analysis for this model, where we are going to know the reactions at the support, the shear force diagram, and the moment. So this right here there are messages that are, it's not really a problem here. So we are just going to click on done. So it's going to run this analysis. So the analysis, this is a window where the analysis was done. So this is how our beam is deflecting under the 30 kilonewton load. So let's change our windows to this window so that you can see perfectly how it looks like. So let's close this window and set it in the elevation. So elevation one, apply, then okay. So this is how our beam is going to deflect under the load. So let's check the reactions at the supports. So we have display support reactions, and now we have our load that we placed on the beam was a dead load. So a dead load, if it's a live load, you change it in arrows, and it's in the direction of the FZ. This FZ is in this direction, the load was in that direction, so FZ, then apply. Looking at this, we have 38.57, and that's the same here, but now it's not supposed to, that's not what we are supposed to get, since this is a 30 kilonewton load, and in the middle we are supposed to get around 15 kilonewton here and also at this support, but we had 38.56. I'm going to explain why it was so. So click on OK. There is something we should have done. So right here, we know that every beam has its own self-weight. So the self-weight of this beam was also included in running the analysis of the model. But in our model or in our drawing, the self-weight was included. So we are going to send this self-weight to zero. We are going to neglect the self-weight. So we are going to edit this model. So in order to edit that, we have to open this lock. Because if you try editing something, you wouldn't be able to do it. So you have to open it, then select OK. So now you can make an editing here. So as I said earlier, you have to select the frame you want to alter, and we also have, you come to assign, you come to frame, then property modifiers. You are going to model this beam and send the self weight to zero. So right here we have mass here, we are going to send the mass to zero, and we also have weight here, we are going to send our weight to zero. So right now we are sending the self weight to zero, so apply and okay. Right now we have PM. So PM here, that's the axial load, and the M is the moment. So axial load and moment, due to this beam is being neglected, the asterisk here. So once it's done, we are going to run the analysis again and see if you get that 15 at the supports. So we are running the analysis again. So this is how the beam is going to deflect. This just a normal message, just ignore it. So this is going to be how it's going to deflect. Let's check the reaction at the support again. So we have the FZ here, apply. After we neglected the self weight of the beam, just look at that. We now have 15 here and also 15 here. So now everything is okay. So okay. Let's check the shear force and the bending moment diagram for this frame. So all you have to do is come to this icon here, display frame or peer So you click on this icon, this is what you get. So let me shift it so you can look at the model well. We have shear tool. So this is where you, if you want to get your shear force diagram, you come. So you have shear tool, that's the main one, and click on apply. So this is basically the shear force diagram. If you want to see the values, you have show values here, apply. They have negative 15 and also 15, one in tension and the other in compression. So for the moment, we have moment 3-3. So moment 3-3, then hit on apply. So this is our moment diagram with the 150 maximum moment here. And that's it for this model. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and to every video you watch. Thank you very much for today.